Your dog can scare and harm animals. These gates have all been left open, you see. Possibly because the locals know that there's no animals, so I don't know. I'm in second gear now. Right, from here I can't see. I can't see the way, but I can see the track. I can just about see the track. Sometimes you'll see horse prints if it's a sort of heavily used bridleway by horses. So there's a video game called Hunter Call of the Wild, and looking for like flattened areas of grass where there's a hoof print where the deer has laid down, and footprints and things like that, and broken twigs and things like that. So sort of the game gives you an idea of how it is in the real world. Oh god, a slippy. There's a little trail. Yeah, so this is a bridleway. It's not a footpath. We shouldn't have any problems getting through. Yeah, this is more of a job with this wetness. Rained heavily yesterday. With this wetness, it's more of a job for the big bike with two of the chain shin, like gravel tyres, sort of like mixed use tyres that I have on it. I think I'll make it with this bike though. Much easier for me to open the gates with this bike, you see, because I haven't got the kickstand. I do want to put a kickstand on it, but it could take a while. So, look. Ooh. I think I'll probably hit the next road sooner than I imagined. Do you get what I mean? This gate is locked a lot better than the other one. Possibly means there's actually animals in here, but I can't see any. A lot of like, it's on a farm, and it's in it's sort of behind Silverstone Racetrack. Oh, I slid sideways there. I slid there. I think I'll use my pedals, because in pedal assist mode, I actually. The motor will put less power down. It's only putting like 300 watts. This is really slippy. This is quite an easy bridleway to follow. It's probably quite heavily walked. I can see, I think, a dog footprint. Could be a fox. Private, no right of way. Well, where the fuck am I supposed to go then? I see, well that's tied there, that's supposed to be tied across there, and it's not. This is the trouble you have, there's no sign to tell you. Luckily I can see some people over there, and I suspect they're following the bridleway. I can also check the ground and look for hoof prints. I can't see any though. Where does that go? Sometimes you just have to use your intuition, as in sense of navigation. And something tells me it might be this way. Not the way those people have walked. No entry. Nice farm. Southern Crabtree Farm, private entrance. I don't know where I am. This looks like a cattle field or a horse field. It looks a bit rough. I don't understand, because animals don't usually walk in a line like that. Well, they didn't used to walk in a line to carve lines through like that. I'm not riding on the line because it's very slippery. Yeah, it should allow me to cross the A5 road. It'll take me through these woods, and then it'll cross the A5 road, and that'll bring me to the edge of Milton Keynes, right? Oh, look, we've got a fence there. Fence there, what's probably supposed to be. So if that fence is supposed to be there, then where does the bridleway go? I'm so confused. Old village. Here we go. Here's the edge. We're gonna make an American style. Oh look. What is missing? Look, the fence is missing. There's the I think the cows have just destroyed it. Or maybe cattle thieves or something? I don't know. Yeah, so they've decided we're going to make a city, and it's going to be in an American style. So all the road layout is going to be American, which is very unusual for England, right? There's no other place like it in England. By the time I grew up, by the time I was born, it was already sort of well established, but it's grown a bit since then. In the middle of it, it has a big half an ice cream cone shaped thing on its side, which is a cinema and a snowboarding ramp thing, an indoor snowboarding centre, and then that's where we used to go to the cinema. It's got a huge car park outside of it, so that's right in the middle. It's a fucking huge building that you can see from miles away. You can see it from like 10 miles away. Across the road from that is another like big shopping centre that I can't remember what it's called, but it's like really, really long. It has loads and loads of shops inside, and it's quite cool because it's got like, it's quite cool because it's got all these sort of palm trees. In the middle, there's like a soily thing, a plant container, like in a stone wall, and it has plants inside of it, and it has all these like tropical plants, and you can sort of you walk either side of it, and then you've got shops either side. And it's got all these like little stalls. It's got all these like stalls in the middle of it. Along, I don't know which way it is. I thought it went around that edge of that field, but that looks pretty rough. And it looks planted. I think I'll probably go the other way, right up to that house, right? Yeah, so you got shops like GameStop, HMV, clothes shops, jewellery shops, music shops, sweet shops, all sorts, electronics stores, just all sorts of stuff. Okay, if this is a bridleway, it's very, I think it might be around the edge there. Probably the wrong way, but both ways looked shit, didn't it? Get what I mean? It's not a great idea to go across the field on this bike, but don't have much choice. I'd rather go up here where it's drier, right? So I can get through there if I need to. I think I'm supposed to go basically behind these houses. It's probably this way. Behind there. I should start to see things I recognise soon. Hopefully no one's back in their garden. This would be a lovely place to live though, wouldn't it? This sort of place. Hopefully, no, we've got a big garden, but hopefully no one's watching, because I may be going the wrong way. So it looks like grass to me. It might be crops, it just looks like grass to me. Should be here. Should be around here somewhere, or down there. I've got to go, I think it's just behind these houses. Feels like somewhere not many people go through here. I think it's through here. This is before the internet. Oh, this is cool. I don't think it can get through there. Yeah, so when I looked on Google, there was a van parked there, and I'm worried, like, I wanted to be able to get round that van. It's right near someone's property, you see. Oh, look at that, it's all jammed up in my... Just get that out. Yes, that could be why. Didn't see many horse prints and stuff. Oh god, this is terrible. Yes, you got some rough areas in Milton Keynes and Bletchley. Bletchley is where the Alan Turing did the Enigma machine during World War II and all that famous stuff. Bletchley is rougher from what I remember. There's like a pawn shop there where you sell things and buy second hand. Not the other meaning. I remember going to like a job centre there once. This is hard work. I've gone through like, feels like three gates already, just in this bit. There's probably another one after this. This should be the last one. It looks easier to get to. Animals in here. Could be a big dog. This looks like an allotment or something, doesn't it? It's another machine. Yeah, I saw this van. And where's the bridleway? Not there, obviously. Here? No, it's tied up. I'm sure it's around here somewhere. supposed to take me through those woods. Gotta go around there. I may have to lift my bike over that. I'll get around that. I think I'll just throw my bike over. It'll get me to the main road if it's good. This is where I got to before, right? I don't think many people come through here, even though it's pretty close to Milton Keynes. But yeah, so Milton Keynes, like Bicester, Bicester is becoming like Milton Keynes. But Milton Keynes has become this just urban, multicultural place where it's not really English, culturally, demographically anymore. And basically people used to say that Milton Keynes was going to grow so big that it would eat up Buckingham, as in Milton Keynes would just keep building and building until it overtakes Buckingham. That's what the locals used to say. But what's really happened is it's just a cultural thing, so it's more like the people from Milton Keynes, the sort of people in Milton Keynes have just moved to Buckingham and the villages, and just the traffic, probably not many people come here. See how much trouble I had to go through to get through all those gates and stuff, and it's not even winter yet. It would be even worse. That tree looks like it's about to fall. I think it's resting on that way. Yeah, so the other problem is people are, because it's on the train line from London, and it's sort of like it's north of London on the main roads, and it's just past Luton, which is another sort of very diverse urban area, very rough place. People are starting to move up to Milton Keynes from London, Luton and Watford and all those places. Oh my god, there's so many fallen trees. No one's made an effort to clear them. Right, we're near the main road now. I can hear it. The A5. Massive road. We go down and we go to Milton Keynes Hospital. Need strength for this. I've got to cross this A5. Very dangerous road. I'm jamming my bike first. Take a break. Have some water. Unjam the bike. Thank you. Welcome to hell. Also known as Milton Keynes. It's going to be very difficult to cross here.
Unaffordable. I stick them in the portable potty and ship them off the portable. They send you entertainers meant to prevent the anger. My righteous indignation may just turn them into stranglers. My curriculum coordinates your thinking order. I'm the reason why they have to fluoridate the drinking water. I'm the reason they set up a forced medication plan. I'm the reason FEMA's building more concentration camps. I'm the reason elitists are meeting up in secrecy, developing a virus to assault your sense of decency. I'm the reason they've been paying people in the blogosphere to poison the well and muddy the water so it's not as clear. You're the direct result of a gimmick and a profiteer, beholden to a puppeteer. Homie, get the fuck out of here.
Tis the season.
Said it, did it. Father thought it. Forget it, found it, ended, won't it?
Someone freedom.
Consider thought it. Brought it, did it, heard it, doubt it, doubt it.
Now you'll see them.
Consider thought it. Gone it. Forget it, found it, ended, won't it?
I'm the reason.
Forget it, gone it, found it, ended, you blow the blue it.
My entire area. I think it's the A5. Is it the A5? It's even worse than the one from Buckingham to Milton Keynes. And yeah, all the time you're waiting to cross the road, you're absorbing the pollution from the car's exhaust and tyres. I feel very sorry for people who grow up in places like this and then they don't know any different, and so they don't even realise that there's something wrong with how, you know, where they live or how they live. That must have taken over 10 minutes. I'm not sure how long it took. It took a long time. But they brought in over a they said the Conservatives said when they were re-elected, they said they were going to have keep it under 100,000 immigrants per year, and they brought in over 1 million last year. Something like that, right? People aren't having children, so we need to bring in 100 million Africans to otherwise the Japanese people won't survive. Ooh, slippery. Of course they don't think like, oh yeah, what if their economy was better and they didn't have to live in like tiny houses in Tokyo, maybe they'd feel more inclined to have children if they didn't have this like corporate culture. I'm completely lost, to be honest. I see a road there. I'm not sure I can get out here. It's very locked up. I don't think this is the way, although it looks like it. So, the reason you don't see any wild animals in my videos is because they're all dead. They're all replaced by cars and roads and houses and factories and crop fields, farm fields, and animal field, cows and sheep fields to feed all the people who the government decided should be here. Decided for us that they should be here, basically. Oh, fucking hell, it's locked. This one's locked as well. Oh, maybe I can get through here. So, the England everyone thinks of when they think of England, you know, the England from the Victorian era, all the novels and, you know, World War II, World War I, Sherlock Holmes, On the Buses, Carry On, and all that sort of programs from that era, films. Doesn't really, you know, Dam Busters, that England doesn't really exist anymore, or it won't. What's left of it won't exist for much longer. Well, indefinitely. You know, it's hard to completely get rid of it, but they're doing their best. They just want everywhere to look the same. They can't think like people used to. They can't just use common sense and like crossing the road. Taking 15 minutes to cross the road isn't healthy for us. Things like that. I think all of these, that's a Mandela effect, that was never like that, you see. These lines here were never there. And they weren't, well, they weren't painted on for me anyway. For me, they weren't painted on. For someone else, maybe they saw them get painted on, but for me, those lines could not have been painted on. Timeline that I'm from. or that the timeline that I can perceive doesn't make sense as to how those lines could have got there. I've been going for a long way and really only just getting started on this bridleway actually. I've got a long way to go still. Because it's easier once you know where you're going, and if you have a bit of luck crossing the road. So we've got a bit of a bridleway here that's going to take us to the edge of Milton Keynes, basically, which is over there somewhere. Oh, what's up here? Check this out. I don't know where I'm going now. I like this place. It's cool. It's pretty over there. That might be the Oakley Woods that I'm supposed to be going round the back of. There's like a high security prison around there somewhere. I can't remember where it is. I can't remember what it's called either, but it's near Milton Keynes. Should be somewhere around here. Going to keep following this track because I think it probably goes where I want to go. Might be here, yeah. If it is, I don't know. There's a gate there that looks openable. Maybe it's back. I'm getting quite warm actually. No, very, you know, Dad's Army, very sort of nationalistic, patriotic, you know, English. Culture where we were very, you know, we were polite people who were proud and we had our own sort of set of values that was different from the rest of the world, and we were sort of respected around the world because of that, because of our engineering, our inventions, mathematics, our honour in battles and whatever, our poetry and all this. But now we're in this sort of globalist thing where we abandon our own beliefs and we you know, any sort of rationale that we had about our nation's decisions in the past, it's just, we go back on our own. We rewrite, you know, we overrule our own decisions and... back tire slid a bit there. Yeah, I expected to see more people out here on the edge of MK, but thought there might see a few. But yeah, we just, you know, we brand our past decisions as morally wrong and evil, and we say, you know, colonialism was terrible but didn't colonialism result in the globalist world that we have today, you know, that people think is good? Oh, lovely tree. It's cool. That's really cool. But anyway, I see all of this as a sort of theatric narrative, a bit like a story that people believe in, that's actually kind of fictional. Just that it looks real, right? It's convincing, a convincing narrative that seems organic and believable, like this is how the world progressed and turned out, and these people made these decisions and all this. But I guess really it's a story that was sort of planned out in advance for people to buy into, and these events, the events were illustrative, or they provided, they played out the story that was already conceived, right? But to us, you know, our past seems like it was real. It was, you know, natural, whereas the present to many of us seems artificial and radically different in nature. Whereas now I think that both epochs were artificial in nature, but one of them was more preferable to most of the people who existed at that time, and me as well, right? I don't really like the direction that the world's going in, or has gone in. I feel much more comfortable in the past, right? But that doesn't mean the past was correct. And I don't mean in a sort of anti-colonial sense. But it means that people's beliefs in the past were as artificial as they are now. It doesn't mean that some of those beliefs weren't closer to what's truly moral. These are all new builds, though. This edge of Milton Keynes is completely expanded. Look how artificial they look. See it? I don't know what was here before these houses were built, so I can't really say. I didn't come here in the past, so I don't know what was it. Probably a field. Slippery. I could ride on the road, but I don't really want to. Fallen tree there. Yeah, I don't want to go into Milton Keynes because it's there's no point. This will take me continuously for a long way. When you go into the middle of Milton Keynes, towards the middle, you're gonna see more criminal types of people that you don't want to see. More trouble. Oh, that goes into those woods there. Look. Yeah, there might be footpaths, you see, because I didn't see a bridleway going through those woods, but yeah, it could just be footpaths, and I'm guessing that's popular. But I would also guess that that's the sort of popular spot for crime, drugs, gangs, maybe even sex crimes, that sort of thing. Drug deals, anything, gang stabbing, anything like that. It's all possible in Milton Keynes. My brother moved away from that, from here, a couple of years ago because it was getting too bad for him. And his daughter was misbehaving in the schools. I think it's this way. His daughter was misbehaving in the schools and stuff. And throwing chairs at teachers and things. I think she's been well behaved since she moved to Buckingham though. So, from what I've heard anyway. Yeah, so this bridleway will actually go on for quite a way. Oh, there's another path through there. There's loads of opportunities here. I have to be careful not to get a puncture. I've got two spare inner tubes though, so pick up some speed here, can't you? Yeah, so I thought it'd be quite accessible because it's along the edge of Milton Keynes, so you get quite a lot of traffic. Yeah, I see quite a long way across there. Ow! Ow! I just put my hand out. Uh-oh, we've got a big bramble there. I put my hand out and I caught it on a big bramble thing that I didn't realise was there. That's why I like the leather gloves, because leather welding gloves I used to wear, the brambles, the thorns wouldn't catch on them. Yeah, could go quite quick down here on the stealth bomber, couldn't I? It is about 7 or 8 miles from town though to the start of this. What's going on there? New builds probably. Disgusting. People said, people used to say, eventually Milton Keynes will swallow up Buckingham. And I think, you know, it's already happened culturally with all the new builds around Buckingham, but they are also expanding Milton Keynes slowly. So, gonna eat into the countryside. You'll have more and more traffic on the country roads. You wouldn't want to be alive. You wouldn't want to be someone with my perception or personality, standards of living, whatever, in 20 or 30 years, you wouldn't want to be alive in this country if you were someone from the old England, from the old world, you know. It's getting rough here, isn't it? This is all new build shit, isn't it? Yeah, look. Disgusting. Didn't know I was going through any new builds. I thought it would all be on the right hand side of me. All be on the right hand side. I didn't know they were doing it on the other side. Didn't think I'd have to go right through the middle of it. Just skirt along the edge. I don't know if it's possible to to go from the current time to the past. Look at this. Disgusting. Yeah, I don't know if it's possible to go from the current time into the past of this world's timeline. Well, there's different timelines, but you know, I don't know if it's possible to go back to Victorian London when you reincarnate, if you've lived in this time, or if you can only go into the future. But I do believe there are other physical worlds that have a potentially completely different. Oh my god, what a bunch of cunts! Look at this. Look at this shit. It's like living in a CGI render, isn't it? Yeah, good. It's good if you're an African who lives in a mud hut, but if you have any standards as an English person, you'd never want to live in this trash. But yeah, like Philip K. Dick said, his novels are based on his perception of alternate worlds that have completely different societies and perhaps geography. Fuck's sake, what is this shite? What am I looking at? What the fuck is this? Urban shite, that's what it is. Yes, I believe there are different physical worlds. How you actually access those, I have no idea. Can you actually transfer across to them when you die or something? I don't know. Or will they send you straight back to this world, you know, immediately as another person? You could end up as a Chinese man, then, you know, maybe. I do suspect that we carry on some of our personality, possibly even our gender, is a facet of our soul, and it's not part of our physical body. Because people change throughout their lifetime. You know, people's personality can completely change throughout their lifetime. honestly, I don't know the answer to that, but I imagine, you know, on some level, if I'd be similar on in some ways in the next life. Oh, you fucking cunts. Bunch of absolute cunts. How am I supposed to get past it? The road's just there that I need to get onto. How much are they fucking building? All the way across this? Probably. All these fields. Going, possibly. It'll all be one connected city, effectively. Like one giant mega city. There won't be any countryside, there won't be any fields or trees. It'll all be artificial. And, what is this shit? Can't even get down the pavement. Why is he going this way? On the wrong side of the road, twat. This feels like it's not even finished. Yeah, Watling Academy, that's probably open already. Should be ashamed of themselves. Yeah, they've got to work to eat, but look what you're contributing to. Yeah, eventually it'll be one giant mega city like Cyberpunk Edge Runners. Well, even in Cyberpunk Edge Runners, they've got a desert. They've got an area outside the sea that's like a wasteland. That's a different one. I've not seen that type before. Here's one of our new residents. Yeah, I didn't plan to come through here. I wanted to keep following that bridleway that they've blocked off. This will take me to one of the main roads in Milton Keynes, I think. At least they've got a wide area so you can cycle along it. That's a big curve, isn't it?
When this guy came to my lane, he tried to get us to surrender. I was mad, but did not flame. Cause sometimes I get nervous when I see a Russian name. Close your eyes, take the loss. Suka blyat, are they human? Cancer, my team is loving, my hope is gone, and I'm on my lane, trying not to answer. Are they human, or are they cancer? Jungle LC and her butch rushed MKB. Then I saw our carry sniper fuck up his lane and go 0-3. My team is Slavic. My hope is gone, and I'm on my lane, trying not to answer. Suit up the odds, are they human?
This is the road I remember coming down. This is the road I entered Milwaukee's from once on my bike. Give all these people the evil eye, to be honest. Shame on you, shame on you. Saved if they hadn't blocked that fucking right away.